friends, today we will have a small briefing on various products, allied activities, dairy and poultry, etc., and marketing. Let us see some of the products. Let us see the dairy. Here, dairy is financed. One is for production of milk, and then cattle for draught, that means for plowing purpose, then purchase of dairy equipment and value addition to milk. All these things we have to take into consideration while financing dairy unit. What are the animals we can give under dairy scheme? One is black cattle, that is nothing but buffaloes. Then white cattle, those are cows. And another thing is sheep and goats also can be given under dairy scheme. Then number of cattle, how many we can give? Minimum 2 at an interval of 6 months. And just cow or pregnant animals we have to give here. Then the some of the breeds which we can finance. Here in buffaloes, Murrah buffaloes, that is graded Murrah buffaloes, then Neely buffaloes, then Surti buffaloes and Jafarbadi buffaloes. Then in respect of the cows, we can finance Sahiwal, Red Sindhi, Gir, Thar-Parker. And in respect of the exotic cows, that is foreign cows, here Holstein Friesian, Jersey, Brown Swiss and Red Dane. And in respect of the crossbreed, please note it here, Carvan Swiss or Carvan Fries. This is very, very important. Identification and age of the animals. While purchasing the animals, the field officer should know which type of animal and what is its age, depending upon their teeth. Sometimes the sellers will do, this is a very young animal like this, they will tell. But by seeing the teeth, then you can know the age of the animal. Here you see. 4.5 to 5 years means fourth permanent pairs of incisors, that is teeth, will come. The site should be located high well-drained land, that is most important, and away from water logging area and nearer to road or nearer to milk road. Then exposure to sun, protection from wind. And one more thing, clean water supply should be there. Then trained labor and marketing arrangements. All these things we have to ensure while selection of site. Land should be prepared nicely and it should ensure housing the cattle and cultivation of fodder and also climate. Here, extreme to be avoided. Extreme cold or extreme hot should be avoided. So, necessary precautions we have to take here. And availability of the good quality animals also to be ensured. Here, in addition to the grazing facilities, that is for dairy cattle, we have to see veterinary aid, that is timely vaccination and curative therapy, and breeding facilities also should be there for bulls for breeding and artificial insemination. For getting good quality calves, artificial insemination with good breeds to be made. The bankers also to look into the most important aspect is marketing arrangements of the milk, because milk is a perishable commodity, spoiling commodity. So there should be a tie-up with society. So immediately they will be marketed and chilled. So here what my banker has to do, whether tie-up arrangements is there or not, then what is the price they are paying? And what is the pricing system? That means it depends upon the fat content. And what is the any other payment method? Whether they are directly crediting to the borrower's account or they are giving cash. All these things we have to verify. The dairy unit is to be financed as per the NABARD unit cost from state to state. Okay, that we have to follow. A 10% to 15% variation also can be allowed here, subject to approval from the sanctioning authority. While financing not only unit cost but also demand and supply, sometimes the supply of the animals will be more, so at the death the cost will be less. Then availability of the animals, then types and breeds of the animals, and health and age of the animal. If it is a old age, the animal will be less cost. So all these things we have to verify while financing. Then lactation and milk yield also, the banker has to see while financing the dairy animals. And in the unit cost, it has to be taken construction of the shed and how many animals it can accommodate. All these things they have to verify. Here, in respect of the dairy, the housing also, for as per age group, we have to provide the space for the animals. Even pregnant cows, we have to give more space. Then, what are the equipment? One is tie chains, that means to tie the animals. Then trolley cots and feed and water troughs and chaff cutter and milking pails and milking machines and bulk coolers and pasteurizer or sterilizer and cream separator, milk vending machines and milk tankers. All these also can be included in dairy finance. In respect of the dairy project, purchase of concentrated feed also very important. This is in addition to the green grass or dry grass. What are the concentrated feed? Edible oil cakes, bran and cotton seed and sugar cane tops, jaggery, all these will come under concentrated feed. This is very important, that is feeding. And while lactation, the green fodder should be more. And concentrate, that is oil cake etc., also to be more, and dry fodder can be less. Whereas in respect of the dry days, the green fodder will be less and dry fodder will be more and concentrate feed will be less. Like that we have to calculate and we have to give feed. Almost 50 to 60% of the total project cost, recurring cost, is nothing but feeding the animals. Please see manger for feeding. Here margins around 15% if the unit size is very big. Small size you need not maintain any margin. Then interest as applicable to the agriculture advances from time to time. Insurance, it is mandatory for items and animals to be insured. And one more thing, the repayment is total period is around 5 to 9 years. The gestation period is around 6 months, and mode of repayment, it is better to fix up monthly, because security, hypothecation of animals and sheds, equipment, feed material, and collateral security, no collateral security up to certain limit. And for small farmers, we need not take any collateral security. For big farmers, for big units, we can take collateral security as equitable mortgage of land and third party guarantee. This type of milk chart to be prepared and ensure how the milk is coming, and LP means lactation period, and DP means dry period. Dry period means there will not be any milk. Please see appraisal of a commercial dairy. Here, this is model exercise on dairy. You please see. Mr. Prasad Farms proposed to establish a dairy unit with 40 graded Murra buffaloes in their 10 acres farm. Just you see. And remaining all these things, please note down. The Murra buffaloes with a milk yield of 8 liters per day, costing rupees 45,000 each, let us say. Now the cost may vary from time to time. This is the milk rate. Milk rate also now vary. All these things, just only for example I am giving. These are the lactation days and cost of borewell, water tank, all these things we have to take.
please see other particulars, just you see and note down here: sale of manure, sale of culled animals, and insurance premium, depreciation, etc., all these things, labor cost and veterinary aid. Now calculate the DSCR basing on the following repayment program: first year 3 lakhs, second to fourth year 3.8 lakhs and fifth year 3.45 lakhs. Please see once again, this is an exercise, you have to do it. Now see the solution. Here we have to prepare milk chart first, that is lactation means milking days and dry means no milking days. For first batch, second batch and total, how many lactation days we will get and how many dry days we will cut, all these things we have to calculate here up to 50 year. Then income from milk, around 40 buffaloes, approximate the value of the milking and all these things. Lactation days we have to take now, on the basis of the lactation days, how much milk has come and what is the amount he has got. All these things we have to calculate here. This is solution and you can prepare also. Then feed requirement during the lactation and dry days per animal, all these things we have to calculate. Then feed cost, on that basis feed cost to be calculated. Now see the term loan requirement, the shed cost and shed and civil construction cost, all these things we have to take into consideration in the project cost. Store room, borewell, water tank, all these things we have to do the exercise. Then the total term loan required after promoter's margin reduction is around, please see, 17,84,625. Let us say 17.85 lakhs. Please note down, then you can understand. So this is repayment schedule: first year, second year, third year, fourth year and fifth year, and by fifth year we should get back the total loan. Then here year wise gross income, you see year wise we have to calculate, and in fifth year 18,64,800, because of the value of the culled animals also. Let us say some depreciation also we have to calculate like this, on building as well as equipment, and we have to arrive the total cost after fifth year. Then we have to calculate year wise recurring expenditure. What is recurring expenditure? Feed is the main amount, and then insurance and cultivation of fodder, all other cost also we have to calculate: first year, second year, third year, fourth year, fifth year, etc. So we have to calculate labor charges, miscellaneous expenses, depreciation, interest on term loan, etc. for all 5 years together, and we have to arrive DSCR year wise 1.79, first year 1.81. So DSCR is increasing, that means his profit is increasing now, that's why DSR also will increases. So on an average it is coming to 2.07. how it is calculated, you see, gross average DSCR, this amount divided, that is profit divided by installment repayable, it is coming to 2.07. please note it. So we have to calculate the gross DSCR like this. Here 40 lakhs 91,024, this is the total net surplus, plus 2,58,676, this is depreciation that we are adding back here. So even though depreciation is, it is a notional, and then here 5,99,400, that is interest on term loan also we have to add it, and again we have to divide the same. Here 17,85,000 plus 5,99,400, that is interest on term loan, again we are adding here and we are arriving 2.07 DSCR. 17,85,000 is nothing but a repayment obligation, you please see here.
I have given in my previous video about the importance of the agriculture and other activities in agriculture. That link I am providing here, and you can see that video. Let us see what is poultry. Poultry is nothing but commercial rearing of birds. It includes chicken, ducks, turkeys, quail birds and geese and guinea fowls and ostrich birds, etc. It is for eggs as well as meat and other byproducts.
Poultry is nothing but commercial rearing of birds, chicken, ducks, turkeys, quail, geese, guinea fowls, etc.
In respect of the poultry, the banker has to see the applicant, then site selection, then shed construction, then what is the breed or strains he is taking, and feed availability, and diseases, and what are the precautions he is taking, and what are the management practices, then project norms and schemes also, whether it is a broiler or egg laying. All these things the banker has to verify. In poultry, one is for egg laying, second one is broiler farming. That is, broiler means meat purpose. These both types we can study here.
These are the breeds of white leg and brown egg efficiency. Babcock, Decalop, all these are the breeds. These are the breeds of the broilers.
Some of the technical terms in respect of the poultry. One is economic life of the bird, that is 72 weeks. Then brooder, it is 8 weeks. Grower, 20 weeks. Brooder and grower means these are small chicks. Then layer, 21 weeks to 72 weeks. That is around 52 weeks, that is 1 year, they will lay the eggs. Cull, that means the removing of birds after their economic egg laying is completed. The site should be located high well drained land, that is most important, and away from water logging area, and nearer to road or nearer to milk route, then exposure to sun, protection from wind. And one more thing, clean water supply should be there, then trained labor and marketing arrangements. All these things we have to ensure while selection of site. The layer sheds, let us see, 1+1+5 system model, that is one brooder shed, one grower shed. Grower and brooder means small chicks, okay. Then 5 layer shed, and all these things should be in cage system.
This is cage system of birds.
Here for broilers also we have to follow the floor space norms. Starter, in broiler, first to 4 weeks, up to 4 weeks chick are called as starters. Here they will be in deep litter system, that means no cages, only flooring will be there with rice husk and all these things they will apply. And finisher is 5 to 8 weeks. That means after 8 weeks, they will be set for meat purpose. So around 8 weeks, all birds will be removed and they will be sold. This system also to be followed in respect of the broiler. The space will be less.
Please see the floor space requirement for brooder, that is 0 to 8 weeks chicks. And this is deep litter means they will be freely move in this deep litter system, and whereas in cages means they will be confined to one cage, and growers 9 to 20 weeks, and layers here egg laying time we have to give more space. For broilers also like this, in deep litter system the space will be more, and in cages the space will be less, because in deep litter there will be moving of the birds are there.
For 10,000 birds, the shed construction, always please note it, it should be east to west orientation. There should not be direct sunlight to fall in the shed. That is most important. On the birds, it should not fall direct sunlight. Then length will be around 100 to 400 feet. Width will be around 25 to 35 feet. Height will be 16 to 22 feet. And cages mounted on the floor, and cages mounted at 6 feet high. And roof, tiles, light roof, asbestos, whatever it may be, let us see the shed construction.
That means the birds are put it in cages, and it is very easy to clean and collect the egg also. And the space should be left here, that litter and all these things will fall, and it will be used as a manure also. This is another type of feeding system of poultry birds. There are waterers, that means watering of the chicks, that is hen. You can see. Foggers, sprinklers and cooling system is very much necessary, particularly to protect the birds from the heat. This is called as deep litter system. Here the birds are freed like this, and rice husk and sawdust will be used as a floor. These are the poultry feeders, trays. This is incubator and hatcher, and once the eggs are kept inside, and chicks will come automatically after particular incubation period is over. See how the chicks are coming from the eggs. They are put in the incubator. Here, these are the brooders. Small chicks are kept here, and the temperature is controlled according to the requirement of the chicks. Vaccinators. This is vaccination program of the poultry units. Transport and marketing also we have to verify.
The poultry is efficient conversion of feed to animal protein of high biological value.
Please see the nutrient value of the cow milk and meat and eggs.
There are some constraints in poultry units. One is sudden and unplanned increase of hatchery capacity leading to severe slump. Then sudden and mushroom growth of small hatcheries producing chicks of doubtful quality. Then fluctuation and sudden increase in feed prices and variable feed quality and deficiency in quality of feed and lack of awareness of least cost ration. And one more thing, inadequate disease diagnostic facilities and biosecurity measures and extension education, all these are the constraints in respect of the poultry units. These are backward linkages, what we will call. And what are the forward linkages? Lack of infrastructure and organized marketing facilities. Once eggs are produced, they have to be marketed. And low capacity of the processing units. And one more thing, non-availability of rural markets for all these things, and no commodity markets. All these things are one of the important constraints in respect of the poultry. There is an alternative to the poultry. That is, poultry means usually we will think these are chicken and all these things. But you can grow alternate to poultry. That is, one is turkey birds, then duck birds, then ostrich birds and emu birds and guinea fowl, then quails. All these things, quills what we will call. And all these things you can grow for as an alternate poultry, and farmers are reaping benefits under this thing.
Nowadays, these emus are also taking by the farmers on commercial basis. In alternative poultry, turkey, you can see the size of the birds and etc. and breeds also.
The ducks also very good source for eggs. Almost 130 to 140 eggs per bird per year.
This is about the duck farming. Around 130 to 140 eggs per bird per year will come. You see. In alternative to chicks, we can go guinea fowl also. Here, 60 eggs per season it will give. Please see it. And best table food, meat is tender, everything is good. Wherever feasible, these quail birds also can be financed. These quail birds are very miniature form and cheapest source of animal proteins. All these things you can see. It is also an emerging area. Let us see the small exercise on broiler production. This is very important. Just you note down all these things. 2500 one day old chicks received alternate weeks, and a maximum of 4 age groups are present at any time in the farm. All these things you have to calculate, floor space, etc. Then miscellaneous expenses like labor, etc. also you have to calculate, and repayment in 5 years. All these things you have to calculate. Just note down all these things. And now what we have to calculate is bird flow chart we have to prepare. Then term loan requirement we have to calculate. And working capital assessment we have to calculate. Cash flow and DSCR and IRR. DSCR means debt service coverage ratio. And IRR means internal rate of return. This is bird flow chart. So we have to prepare year wise rearing weeks and cleaning weeks. Cleaning weeks means no birds will be there and we have to clean entire sanitization and all these things we have to do. And rearing weeks when birds stay in the house. The broilers will stay around 8 weeks in a shed and the cleaning period will be 2 weeks. A field officer should prepare this worksheet for appraisal. Cost of construction, that is fixed investment, storeroom, etc. Then working capital assessment, chicks cost, feed cost, all these things we have to calculate in this proforma. Then calculate income and expenditure by sale of broilers, and in expenditure chick cost, feed cost, etc. separately. For 2500 broilers we have to calculate like this. Then we have to calculate what is the amount of surplus we got batch wise. Then depreciation of building and machinery also we have to do like this. Then calculate the repayment and DSCR. DSCR means debt service coverage ratio. That is whether a repayment obligation, whether he is able to generate profit which is sufficient for repayment or not, we have to see in DSCR. Here you see DSCR means net surplus plus depreciation. Depreciation means it is a notional amount. So net surplus plus depreciation plus interest on term loan divided by annual principal repayment plus interest on term loan. All these things we have to calculate and we have to get DSCR. So whether the unit is generating income which is sufficient to meet, or more than that, it has to receive the income for repayment of the installments. Then we have to calculate cash flow and IRR. IRR means internal rate of return. The internal rate of return should be more than the what bank interest will do. So if the bank interest is around 7 to 10%, at least they have to earn more than 15 to 20% IRR. Then only it is viable. Otherwise, it is not viable. This is IRR calculation. That is IRR. This is the formula: lower discount rate plus difference between the two discount rates into net present worth at lower discount rate divided by difference of net present worth between lower and higher discount rates. We have to here calculate at around 15%, 20% discount rate in IRR. You can see in my previous video about the IRR. Then field officer has to give his comments on the viability of the proposal.
Let us see the economic parameters of the ship. The unit size will be 20 to 30 EVs, that is a lady ship and one ram, and 10 to 20% culling per year from third year onwards. The unit cost will be as per the NABARD unit cost. It will change from year to year. And lambing intervals will be 12 months. And lambing rate will be around 75%. And males sold at 8 to 9 months. Females should be retained. And shearing, that is taking of wool twice a year, can be taken. The adult sheep will give around 1.2 kg of wool per year, which can be sold in the market, which is additional income to the farmer. And in addition to that, proper vaccination to be done for against the diseases, and also necessary care to be taken for the sheep, and health also to be checked. And if there are any diseased ram or ewe, that is sheep, is there, it should be immediately removed.
These are some of the breeds of sheep. This sheep is very good for wool as well as meat. It is a dual purpose breed. It is very good. Quality also very good. Meat quality also very good. Here lambs, that is small sheep on stall feeding. You see, like that we can feed. The sheep can be grown in pasture lands for open grazing, you can see. If the farmer is having any barren land, he can cultivate stylo grass for the feeding of the sheep. Wherever feasible, goat rearing also can be encouraged. These are the different varieties of the goats. The goats are reared for meat as well as milk, and the unit cost differs from state to state as per the NABARD unit cost, and here shed etc. to be constructed according to the unit cost. The repayment is 6 years with a grace period of 1 year. Wherever feasible, piggery finance can be done as per the unit cost of the NABARD. Here, quick returns and minimum labor and per unit meat production is very high, and good returns, quick returns. The unit size will be 10 plus 1, that means 10 female ones and 1 male one. And here the unit cost is as per the NABARD unit cost for that state, and margin is 20%, and repayment is 5 to 6 years. Here, in respect of the piggery unit, necessary spacing should be given for growers and pregnant pig and all these things. And for pregnant pig, there should be more spacing. Wherever feasible, rabbit rearing also can be financed. There are different breeds are available: heavy variety, medium weight, all these New Zealand white and Californian. Here it will give 3.5 to 4 kg this New Zealand white, and where is heavy variety, the white giant and grey giant, it is gives more than 5 kgs. This is a lightweight Himalayan Dutch rabbit. Here it will give up to 2.5 kgs. Please see it. some wool breeds also available, that is Russian Angora, British Angora, Germany Angora, French Angora, it will give 2.5 to 3 cages. The rabbits can be grown in cages wherever poultry holidays are there. We can grow rabbits in those cages. And one more thing, unit size is 10 plus 1. The ratio for male to female is 1 is to 10. And you can use NABARD unit cost wherever applicable. And one more thing, the margin is 10% and repayment is 5 years. In 5 years, yearly installment or quarterly installments, like that you can fix. Now see sericulture. This is nothing but an art of rearing silkworms. In sericulture, two activities can be seen. One is agriculture sector, that is growing of mulberry cultivation and rearing of silkworms. And secondary one is non-farm sector, that also can be financed. In non-farm sector, what are the activities? Reeling, twisting and weaving. All these are non-farm sector. So, as per the estimation and NABARD unit cost, banker can finance both the things. There are around 4 varieties of silkworms you can grow. One is mulberry silk, second one is tussar silk and airy silk, moga silk. But mainly mulberry silk is reared. Mainly mulberry silk. Mulberry silk means the silkworms are grown on mulberry leaves. They will feed mulberry leaves. As a banker, we have to see, one is for mulberry development we have to finance, then for one rearing equipment also we can finance. So rearing house also you can finance, and depending upon the cost and model, you can finance the project cost. The loan repayment will be maximum 4 years, 3 to 4 years. And in case of rearing house, you can give up to 5 years also. And reeling unit, if it is a cottage industry, you can give up to maximum 7 years. So a grace period of 11 months, that is around 1 year, a grace period can be given here. There is a good export market for silk as well as silk products. The main importer of Indian silk is USA. Apiculture is nothing but growing honeybees. Here honey, it is also having a lot of market in India as well as in foreign countries, and it is having export potential also. So as per the NABARD unit cost, this can be financed. Wherever flowers are available, it will be good. Particularly nearer to forest areas, it will be very good, because a lot of flowers and all these things will be available there. Or wherever gardens are there, we can go ahead with apiculture activity. This is a pit, you see, where earthworms are kept and other material will be converted into beautiful fertilizer by the earthworms. Please see the economics of the vermiculture unit. Here we can finance to the farmers who are coming forward to start vermicompost. It is also very profitable venture for the farmers here. So total capital cost, it is around 3.12 lakhs. Please see the operational cost for one cycle, and the total recurring cost for 5 cycles, it is coming to 3,86,000. This is benefits from, see, 200 TPA capacity units. Sale of 200 tons vermi compost is getting 5 lakhs. Like that, we have to calculate and operational cost benefit. And second year onwards, operational cost and benefit is 5,50,000. So net benefit is 1,64,000. You can keep financial outlay and repayment schedule. And average DSCR is here is 2.05. That means it will earn profit repayment. All these things you can calculate. Let us see the PC culture. PC culture is nothing but. PC culture is nothing but growing of fish, prawns, and crab, etc. All these things will come under PC culture. Mainly, fish rearing is called as PC culture. Here, different varieties of fish are available, you see. And Rohu, grass carp, katla, and common carp, and mrugal, and silver carp. Here, if you see the katla, the mouth is upside. That means these are surface feeders. Whatever insects are there in the surface of the pond, they will eat. And if you see the mrugal, you see, here mouth is downside. That means bottom insects in the pond, they will eat. And here, if you see the rohu, the mouth is straight. So these are called as middle feeders. They will feed insects in the middle of the ponds. These are the grass carp and all these things. Depending upon their mouth, they will feed the insects in the pond. This is importance of the pisciculture. There are freshwater pisciculture, brackish water farming, that is prawn. Here in seawater also, they will grow. And wherever nearer to sea, the prawn culture is nowadays picking up. And freshwater fish culture also available in many ponds in coastal districts. And because of their good demand and pond construction, all these things, the government is also giving lot of support. So please utilize, and the unit cost as formulated by the NABARD to be followed, and the repayment, yearly repayment you have to fix. Here we have to give working capital as well as term loan also. Term loans for pond digging, and working capital is for fish feeding and fish seed, etc. Okay, all these things you have to take, formulate the project with the help of fisheries officials and as per the NABARD unit cost, and fix the repayment as usual as per the requirement, particularly yearly repayment to be made in respect of the working capital and term loan, some 5 to 6 years you can put. Particularly, the stocking can be taken like this. Katla, which is surface feeder, 750 species. And Rohu, 1000, and Mrugal, bottom feeder, 750, and silver carp, 750, and grass carp, 750, and common carp, 1000. Total 6 species, 5000 fingerlings we can release in the fish pond. As a field officer, we have to see the water spread area of the pond, and what is the shape of the pond, and depth of the pond, and pond development expenditure also we have to take into consideration. And site selection is also very important in respect of the fish culture. It should be free from flood and inflow of polluted water. That is most important. Otherwise, the fish will die, or if floods will come, fish will go. Here is the problem. So we should see that it is free from flood and polluted water. And assured source of adequate fresh water also should be seen. And land side should have adequately drainaged. All these things we have to see in respect of the selection of fish pond. Further, Monitoring and inspection of the fish unit is very essential. Checking of pond water color and trial netting, etc., all should be done. And harvesting will be taken after 10 to 12 months of the stocking of fish head. So here what we have to do is bank assistant, working capital loan for pond maintenance cost, seed cost, feed cost, all these things. And term loan we can give for site cleaning, new pond construction, and repair and development of existing ponds, and construction of inlet and outlets. All these will be come under term loan. And construction of watchman shed, labor shed also will come under term loan. So here two types, working capital and term loan. All these things we have to assess properly before financing the fish ponds. In the same way, insurance also can be done. Nowadays, this shrimp or prawn culture is also picking up, and it is having very good export quality. And there are two types of the prawn culture. One is brackish water, that is salt water prawn culture, and second one is fresh water prawn culture. Mainly tiger prawn, what we will call, and tiger prawn is most famous in respect of the prawn culture. And for prawn culture also, in the same way, just like fish culture, PC culture, what we have to give is working capital as well as term loan. And term loan is repayable in 5 to 7 years, and working capital it should be repayable within 1 year after selling of the prawn and all these things. But constant monitoring should be there in respect of the prawn culture, and virus free prawn seed only to be taken. And if there are any diseases, immediately veterinary aid or fisheries expert or prawn culture expert opinion to be taken, and keep the pond clean. Here you can also prepare model economics of composite fish culture 1 hectare. Here one is capital cost, second one is recurring cost, third one is project cost, and income and surplus, etc. You can prepare. This is cash flow statement and repayment schedule. All these things you can prepare in respect of the PC culture, that is fish farming.
Nowadays, there is a lot of changes in agriculture. It is changing face of agribusiness, what you say. Today, commercial orientation in farming, then demand-driven production, that is most important.
Here, loans can be extended for purchase of solar pump set, solar water heater, and solar light. All these things you can finance to the farmers. Please see the how the solar energy used, solar thermal technologies, that is heat produced is used to operate devices for heating, cooling, drying, water purification, etc. And solar photovoltaic systems convert sunlight into electricity, and other technologies also you can use for agriculture, for water lifting and pumping. All these things where power supply is not available or erratic power supply is there, this is very useful, and bankers can finance this one. The banker can finance this equipment to the individual farmers in rural and semi-urban areas for their farm needs. The security is hypothecation of this solar equipment, and loan is repayable in 5 to 7 years, yearly in installments.
These are some of the products in agriculture and small briefing of agriculture, so that we can efficiently plan and finance for agriculture activities and develop good agriculture advances. In turn, we will get profit to the organization as well as the country. in my previous video about the importance of the agriculture and other activities in agriculture. That link I am providing here. Thank you.